shit go crazy.
What's going on, my good folks? It's your man, your guy, your boy, 1127 Kicks. I hope everybody out there is having a great day, an amazing day, and overall a blessed day. Say, man, if you're new to the channel, do your boy a huge favor, hit that like button, go ahead and subscribe to the page, and if you're already with the movement, bro, I greatly appreciate you, man. Hit that like button, share this video, and let's go ahead and keep this page growing. So, man, few days outside of the release, you know I gotta keep my word with y'all, man. October 10th, for a retail price of $225, man, we have the Air Jordan 4 PSGs that is dropping. And hey, man, this shoe is a little more hype than what I actually thought, bro. Like, I was really surprised with this shoe, I'm not even gonna lie. But if you're new to the channel, if you haven't seen one of my how to cop videos, we're gonna talk about where you can find the shoe, do I think the shoe will sell out. You know, we're going to talk about resale predictions, StockX, and GOAT. You know, the best sizes you could get if you want to resell and things of that nature. And also where you can find a shoe and stuff like that, man. So just sit back, relax, and post up and enjoy the video. So real quick, man, just getting into the shoe right there, man. As you can see, it's a nice, you know, white upper leather right there, man. And if you see my copper drop video, I did say I like that gray around the toe box because it does remind me of the military blue forest. Then you got your hints of burgundy in there, you got your hints of black in there. Of course, you know, you have the PSG logo that's also on the back of the shoe. Super fire. You know, the colorway is nice, man. I feel like it's gonna be a dope fall colorway, just in my personal opinion right here, man. And on top of that, it's an Air Jordan 4, man. So just with that being said right there, with Air Jordan 4s, just in general, Air Jordan 4 is a dope silhouette. It's really hard to mess up an Air Jordan 4 in my personal opinion. So I do expect this shoe to do really, really well. I actually do expect this shoe to sell out personally. Now, last year with the 6s, when they came out, I was surprised that the 6s sat for so long, but the resale prices on them now are ridiculous. But, and thank God I got them, because those are cold, for real, for real. But with these 4s, man, I definitely feel like it will sell out. I think it will do numbers. That's just in my personal opinion, man. I've seen a lot of people talking about it and things of that nature. So, hey, you really gonna have to be on your P's and Q's, definitely, when it comes to this shoe right here. Now, let's go ahead and talk about this resale, because I know that's what everybody pretty much cares about, man. So let me go ahead and set y'all up for success real quick. So when you look at StockX, you make it, hey, the shoe's going for 300 and up, bro. 300 and up. Now, it's 225, so when you look at it, you know, that's a $75 profit. But at the same time, from what it's looking like right now, this shoe will definitely shoot up over time. But overall, what I'm seeing is that everything is pretty much 300 plus, but when you get to that size 11 and a half on up, that's when you really start to see the profit that you can make. You can make like a little over $100, and there's a few other sizes in there right now where you can make a little over $100, something like that, and profit, man. So honestly, in my personal opinion, I would definitely say if you're getting this shoe, I would definitely say look at that 11 and a half on up, because those are like the big money sizes. Now, that's just in my personal opinion. Of course, y'all know I'm gonna have that StockX, you know, screen recording on the split screen, so you could pause it, look at it and stuff like that, and see, you know, sizes that you are actually looking to resell and everything like that. And then when you go ahead and you look at GOAT, it's pretty much the same thing. 300 plus, you know, something real smooth right there, man. You really can't go wrong. And if I'm not mistaken, when you get to that size 11 and up, hey, that's some big bread right there, or 11 and a half and up. But pretty much for both apps, I would definitely say look at size 11 on up, or 11 and a half on up. And there's a few other sizes in there as well, man, but those are the main sizes that I've seen where, you know, you could really, you know, maximize your profit. And that's just in my, you know, in my personal opinion and stuff like that. But once again, for every size, it's 300 plus. So with that being said right there, man, of course, when the shoe sells out, because it will sell out in my personal opinion, you know, it might go down a little bit, you know, when people start receiving their pairs, but the shoe is definitely going to shoot up. I definitely see that happening. So if you can get your hands on these shoes, I would definitely say get your hands on these shoes if you want to resell them. I feel like it could definitely be a quick flip, but if you hold on to them, you could definitely maximize your profit way more. And that's just in my opinion right there. And like I said, I'm a little surprised, because I didn't think they would be like this, you know, off the rip, but it is. And hey, man, that's more power to y'all, man. That makes me happy, because if you do want to resell, you do want to make a quick buck or something like that, hey, man, you most definitely can. Never getting away with anybody's money. You feel me? That's just me right there. Now, as far as where you can buy the shoe, man, y'all already know what your boy finna say. You already got the Flex app, you know, stories that's going to get them. Foot Action, Foot Locker, Finish Line, Champs, you know, you got your East Bay on there. I believe, you know, Finish Line, they just did their raffles, man, not too long ago. So if you hit on the PSGs, double salute to you, man. Drop a comment in the conversation below. Let me know if you actually hit on Finish Line or not. Then I believe, you know, the Foot Locker, Foot Action apps and stuff like that, that will actually let you go ahead and reserve your shoes as well, man. So go ahead and, you know, get on there, try to reserve your shoes, use your Head Start points and stuff like that. If you don't got enough, spend your little change up at a Foot Locker or something like that or whatever, so you get those Flex app points and you can go ahead and, you know, reserve the shoe and get those Head Starts that you need to give yourself the better chance to actually reserve the shoe, man. Now, other sites that this shoe is actually going to release on is JD Sports, which I'm still confused why the Blue Cement's not on there, but that's a whole nother thing. But JD Sports, they're getting them. DTLR is getting them. City Gear, Hibbit Sports, they're getting them. Chic, they're also getting them as well, man. Of course, like I said, they're dropping on the Sneakers app, 10 a.m. Eastern time. So that in itself right there, man, that's at least 10 spots that's actually going to get these shoes and things of that nature, man. And I'm pretty sure it might be a little raffles going on as well, man. So the best part about that is, and I always say this, man, is that when you have a shoe that's releasing in multiple places and stuff like that, it basically, you don't have to worry about everybody just, you know, flooding one site, because that truly sucks when everybody's just truly flooding one site. You really don't have to worry about that, man. Some people might be on Foot Locker a lot, some people might be on Finish Line or Foot Action because they hit on there more, and shoot, you might, you know, slide on City Gear or DTLR or something like that, and you got yourself an easy cop. Now, this one thing I do want to say, even though these shoes are dropping on different websites, I'm pretty sure they're dropping at many Foot Lockers and Finish Lines and stuff like that, that doesn't necessarily say that this shoe is a huge GR. We don't know the quantity of the shoes that's actually being produced. You also got to remember it's a collab as well, man. So usually collabs are a little limited and stuff like that. We only get one PSG a year, except for last year. I believe we got the ones as well, which is trash. But anyway, you know, that's one thing that you also have to think about as well, man. So like I said, you really want to be on your P's and Q's. So with all the sites and Sneakers app, make sure that your information is updated, make sure your shoe size is good, your cards and everything like that, man, because the last thing that you really want is to check out and then is decline because you got a different card, your address is different, especially with Sneakers. If you order off of Sneakers, you cannot change your address once it's confirmed and stuff like that. They're going to send it straight to the address on file. So make sure you have your address changed as well, man. That's the last thing you want. I don't want that for anybody. I want to make sure everybody gets their pair and it gets to where it needs to go right there, man, because that's the last thing that you really, really want to happen. But pretty much, man, there it is right there, man. Once again, resale on the shoe is great. It's amazing, man. I do expect it to keep on going up, especially after it releases and all the pairs sell out and stuff. I do expect it to go up. And then on top of that, once again, the sites that they're releasing on, you got Foot Locker, Foot Action, Finish Line, Champs, East Bay, JD Sports, Chic, City Gear, or Hibbit Sports. You know, you got your DTLRs. So, hey, man, you got a boatload of sites to actually get this shoe, man. So, once again, bro, like I said before, make sure you just own your P's and Q's, do everything that you possibly can to go ahead and cop this shoe. Just off the simple fact, I don't think this shoe is going to be a truly walk in the park, but at the same time, a truly walk in the park. Anyway, a true walk in the park. But at the same time, I feel like if you do put in the footwork and everything like that, you will definitely be fine. And once again, this shoe drops October 10th for a retail price of $225. That would be 10 a.m. Eastern time, man. So once again, if you're in Cali, that's 7 a.m. I believe you're in Texas, I want to say that's like 8 a.m. And if you're like in the New Orleans area and stuff like that, that's 9 a.m. And if you're all the way in Hawaii, that's 6 a.m. And if it's daylight savings over here, which I really don't know, it'll be 5 a.m. But regardless, it'll be 10 a.m. Eastern time, man. So don't wake up at 10 a.m. your standard time or wherever you at and think the shoe's going to be there. They will not be there, bro. I just got to reiterate that right there, man. But let me know how y'all feel about the shoe in the comment section below. I hope this video is very informational for y'all, man. I just want to say I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Stay blessed. Stay safe. Justice for George Floyd, as always. Y'all already know how we finna end the video off. If you search for good, you shall find a favor. If you search for evil, you shall find you. Proverbs 11:27. and we walk in faith and not by sight. For what is seen is temporary, what is unseen is forever. I live by that, I stand by that, and always remember, bro, anybody could be somebody, and that somebody is you, and that is facts. And it's your boy 1127 Kicks. And always remember, bless your feet with something.
Who to hit me up and told me shit on these niggas? 30 niggas out here came back to go and showing the difference. Keep on dropping all of that shit, M84 on the list. And you know these niggas ain't fucking telling, get out of here.